Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to AstralGames Day 77, Room 2, King of the Britons, Episode 2. Today, we shall venture further into our conquest of Britannia, which we started last week, I believe. Yeah, last week. Zul, welcome to the channel. Thank you for the host, sir. It is good to see you. How are you doing? Let's load the game up and then I shall continue with the announcements. Of which there aren't too many, I believe. Today, this will be the final cast of the week, I believe, because Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday will be my days of work this week. So, and this weekend I shall be playing D&D in real life, with my real life group. So, I will be gone for the rest of the week. Hey, Toby, what's up? What's up? How are you doing? Welcome to the stream. So, this will be the final cast of the week, most probably. Next week I will be... I'll have to look what it's going to be on the casting-wise. But, I believe there is... Wait, next week is already the week of the 19th and the 20th. There might be a very long cast. The 20th. Saturday the 20th. I will be doing a very, very long cast. As I will have the house to myself. And I've got no plans so far. So it will be a really long cast. For sure. I'm not sure if I'm going to do 24 hours. But it's going to be a long cast at least. And part of that cast will be multiplayering with. Or co-oping with Philip Rich 42 as we continue our Diablo characters that we established during the Nominom community event. So that's going to be very interesting as well. That's going to be a part of that cast. And yeah, 24 hours if I want Phil's money indeed. Oh, I thank you, Zul. Thank you. I believe that's next week already. I don't have the view on the date. Can I? No, I can't see it here. Yeah, I think that's next week. And hey, Bookfish from the room beside me. yeah. So that's it for announcements. Obviously, I'm going to fit another King of the Britons episode into my casts next week because I have settled with myself that there's going to be at least one Rome 2 Total War episode every week that I cast. So for every week that I cast, I'll do at least one Rome 2 Total War episode until the release of Attila Total War, the new one, which will be released on... If there are no delays, it will be released on February 17th, which coincidentally was also the very first cast of this channel 1 year ago. So, well, then it's 1 year ago. February 17th, 2014 was the first cast of this channel. So February 17th, 2015 will be the celebration of the birthday of the channel and hopefully also the release of Attila Rome 2. I already have it marked that February 17th. I don't care what I'm doing that day. Even if I have work. Even if I have work, I don't care. I'll be casting after work. I don't care how tired I am. February 17th. Somewhere I shall find time that day to cast Attila and celebrate the 1 year anniversary on Twitch for me. So that's going to be amazing. With that said though, so next week I have work on Monday and Wednesday. Yeah, Monday and Wednesday so far. So we'll see what in between days I shall be casting. So far it's Monday and Wednesday work, so probably Tuesday cast and a Friday cast or something like that. We'll see. And the Saturday cast, don't forget. We must see. Oh god, I should read the future of February 17th in entrails. Oh man, yeah, that's what Sears do, man. Let's jump into the game, guys. Let's jump into the game. There we go. The old layout is back. I changed the layout up from the Diablo stream, of course, since this game does full screen. So let's check out the... Oh, these are the scroll controls. All right. The current situation of our British Empire. We have conquered Britannia, as you can see here. It is fully blue, fully white in this map. This is our land. So that's very good. You're using wordplay. We must see what February 17 entrails. Oh! Now I get it. Tobe. Oh my god. Now I get it. Right, right. I see what you did there, sir. It took me a while, but I see what you did there. Alright, so... we've got Britannia and Scotland. And we are not at war with these guys. So wait, are we at war with no one? We're at war with no one. Okay, so... we'll have to see where our next conquest brings us. These guys hate us, though. So we might just attack the Rugi. They don't have any allies. It's a tempting target. It's a tempting target. Let's look at how our forces... where our forces stand. We've got no forces on the mainland. We've got a bit of a public order problem. Oh, we do have forces on the mainland, which are holding this territory in check.
Ready for battle.
Yep, a small army that holds this territory in check. These guys have public order issues. What is the issue? Events, taxes, slaves. Alright, so some event. Slaves will revolt in 76 turns. Some event is causing this to have minus public order. Obviously, I don't want to use an army to fix it. So, with enough money in the coffers, though, let's see if we can upgrade the public order structure. For minus one food? No, it doesn't give public order. This gives public order. This also gives public order. Wealth from all sources. The Grove of Rosemurta. It will cost us all the money this turn, but we should make sure that our island is, you know, happy. And then here are our very successful conquering armies, led by Namiorix and Koreas, which are on either side of the... Oh man, but Namiorix is way more successful than Koreas. This is quite interesting. It seems that we are losing very much on the political field.
Thirsty for battle.
That means we need to make sure Koreas gets a few more victories. How is this doing? Flavium. Flavium is actually very pissed off, but I guess they still have the conquest. Yeah, next turn only, minus 20. But they're still at minus 4 then. Seal, what is your favorite to the war? Shogun 2 with Fall of the Samurai expansion. is definitely my favorite Total War. Not looking at any time period. Obviously, I'm biased towards the Roman time period because I'm a Roman nerd. Hey, Binary, what's up? I'm a Roman nerd, so that does carry my favor, but just in general, it's definitely Shogun 2 with Fall of the Samurai expansion. That was definitely the best Total War out of all of them, I would say. Okay, could we just transfer? Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 sword bands. That sounds like a character class, yeah. Oh, I don't have those. Okay, let's just transfer this. Oh wait, it doesn't, of course, because it's... Oh, now it does. Accept, okay.
Thirsty for battle!
So Namiorix has the crappy ones.
Ready for orders!
And you have the good ones. Cannot recruit. Oh, of course, no effort. Aw, sorry to hear, Binary, sorry to hear. I hope it all goes well. Alright, so let's wait a turn. And see if we can fix our troops, our treasury. And hopefully keep everything stable. Until we're ready to war again. To go up against the Rugium. A troubled populace. Yeah, I know they're troubled. They're pretty pissed off. Give them a public order building. +2 morale. Or +1 zeal. Niamorix is the one that doesn't go to war, is he? Yeah, he is the one that doesn't go to war. So... Wait, where did the message go? So... You can get the zeal. The zeal's better. At least you get... Good to hear, Zul. Thank you. Thank you for the compliment. Alright, so
ready for orders.
Thirsty for battle.
You, sir, need to step out
I
of the
walk to
town.
The other
you
world
need
for
to
my
step
tribe,
into the
my
town.
Warriors. For the tribe.
Because Koryas is going to
ready
make
for
our tribe
orders.
Stronger.
Ready for
we
orders.
Want more melee or more ranged? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, 5 ranged is enough. Let's recruit some melee. 180. 120. Yeah. There we go. D&D was confusing but great. Yeah, Rotato is amazing. Not just his emotes, but also just as a streamer. Oh hey, look, it already fixed itself. Good. Let's still build the public order structure anyway. Just to make it more secure. Yeah, that's fine. Alright. Oh hey!
I live to serve the people
We've
of Britain!
We've got a War Maiden. Go to Koryas and go military training.
Down
for the tribe
because they
Warriors
need the experience
old.
If they're going up against these guys. Also, can we raise a new army? Yep, we still have an army to raise. Definitely on our side. Definitely an army on our side. Elder Chiefs. Wait, are we the Elder Chiefs? Yeah, we're the Elder Chiefs. Good, good. Minus 9. Yeah. You shall be raising an army. Lead from the back.
I live to serve the people
ready
of Britain.
For orders.
Who's
for
good general try. That leads from the back?
All.
Mr. Killer. You're gonna run inside checks like crazy. Inside checks, man. They are your friend. All right.
Fight with us. It's a good life.
It needs 2 turns anyway, so that's good. We're going to create a small support army. Oh, and now this province has issues. Oh well. Yeah, exactly. Suffering the drools. Well, he was just about to sit on the curse expert, apparently, so... the Pictonus, okay.
Thirsty
don't know
battle.
Who they are, but... as in the game, my... faction doesn't know who they are.
Yeah!
Alright, so we've got a melee core, the Woad Warriors.
Warriors!
Together order. With the Blades of Bella Tukadros. We'll be engaging the enemy soon. They still dislike us, don't they? Yeah, they still dislike us. They like us. Can't we trade?
Greetings to you. I trust you come with...
Nope. No, they don't
I am
trade.
Sure that your wares will find a home somewhere, but...
You
are
trade.
Welcome, although my ancestors...
Nope. No, no one
I do not
trade.
Think our people want your...
Let's see if they want a non-aggression pact to start.
Greetings to you. I trust you come with honorable words today.
Oh, they do have
by
a non-aggression
all the gods,
pact.
Your word
Let's see
hold
if we can get the Numnites to
agree with my heart and tongue to
become our allies and trade partners. They are very happy with us. They condemn past treaties with the Demoni. The Demoni are gone, so we don't have to care for that anymore. They're at war with the Nervii. But the Nervii like us. I don't know if it's smart to go to war with a neighbor that likes you. Even though it might get us more relationship points with the Numnatus. Oh! They do have a military ally. Oh, this one. So then we get to a war with 2 nations. So then we expand like this instead. 2 nations with only 1 province each. It seems. No, 2 provinces. We'll see. First, let's get the armies up before we make any plans.
For the tribe! I live to serve the people of Britain!
Yeah, then it doesn't need as much slinger strength.
Hail to the mother!
How can I help?
Yeah.
I live to serve the people of Britain.
Alright. That's good that you serve the people of Britain. We need that. Yep, it's very chillaxing. Thank you for the kind words. Oh, someone is infamous. We need your help, Senate of the People. A young boy with an uncanny resemblance to a member of your family has appeared. He claims to be the man's son by the daughter of another tribal leader. Will we adopt him? The boy is strong and does seem to favor his father. Will we send him away? There's no proof that this boy is of our blood. Send him away. Or do we do nothing? Let the boy claim what he will. What does it matter? So I will leave it up to you, as always. Senate of my people. Well, I'm British, so I guess it's not a Senate, but I'll leave it up to you, Council of my people, to tell me what to do about this situation. I serve the people of Britain. Because it's Britannia. Spread the word that I challenge Guile to have Roy make Anna serve the great Juju in the sky. I'm not sure if that's very profitable for your character at this juncture, since Juju is an infant god. And I'm not sure if you will have enough power to support a paladin. If he has enough power to support a paladin. So there are no votes on the meta. What shall I do? Uncanny resemblance to your family has appeared. He claims to be the man's son by the daughter of another tribal leader. So if I adopt him, that means that I believe him, which will probably get the man killed. Let's do it anyway. We'll see. We'll see what happens. I hope none of my family members are getting killed because of this decision. So where were we? Yes. Tribe! Recruiting army. That's what we were doing.
Ready for orders!
Wow, that training goes fast. They're already on bronze? Wait, are you... You don't even have upgrades on training yet. Wow. She's pretty good. Alright, so... You're just standing there doing your thing? Yeah. It is a calm, calm time. The calm before the storm has arrived. I'm still thinking of plunging myself into a wall with the guys that are at war with Namnitus. Mother eventually came forward and proved the truth of her son's words. The boy truly is his father's son.
Nice.
So now we have a general, which is somewhere. Yeah, cat called dungeon indeed. Oh, the Swaby are dead as well. There go the Germans. Sorry, Germans. Sorry if there are any Germanic viewers. Wait, so did a general just pop, or? It's a statesman. Okay, it's not a general. It's an, just an extra statesman. Man, if that guy now dies, we're getting a crappy power balance. Oh man. This
ready
is not
for
good.
Orders.
Oh, minus 20, Jesus. We don't have the money to support this army. Damn it.
Hail to the mother. How can I
help? Hold up.
Ready
stop
for
training.
Orders. Ready for battle. The mother protects
just give
travelers.
A few units because they, yeah, they need it for. Just give one every one swordsman. One thingy.
Move out! I live to serve the
there
people
we go.
Of Britain.
Alright, so now the choice remains where to strike. Well, obviously we need to go this way, so.
I would walk to the other world for my tribe.
There we go. Or there they go. Time to conquer for Britain. Four food, seven food. Well, it does give wealth from farming, so upgrade that. A designated cam. Yeah, I have seen streams that use a designated cam for weird stuff. It's usually a keto. Come around specific times and be very quiet. There will be a cat. Alright, so. Let's just go all in and please the Nernites so we can get a trade agreement there. And conquer the Nervii.
I welcome you, worthy speaker. I listen because your people are known to have honor.
You will no longer find me a worthy speaker. For I have engaged you in battle. I'm not sure if this was the best idea, but we're going for it. I'm going to Leroy it. Leroy! Oh, there they are. What up? Oh shit! Like I said, it might not have been the best idea. Damn. Alright, we'll see if we'll survive this one. Oops. Definitely wasn't the best idea. I underestimated their power, I think. The wands of Tutatis. By Tutatis. I underestimated the power. Alright. Well, I will hang back and let the reinforcements reinforce the army.
Ready for battle! Don't break for
formation! Veteran riders!
Always the best idea to plunge headlong into a war with an enemy you can't read the power of.
What Lord of gods?
That might be the
ever since my
enemy reinforcements approaching.
I know, I thought I was prepared, but you were not prepared. That's all I can think of right now. Are they just gonna wait until the reinforcements arrive as well? I would assume so.
Ready!
Ready!
Britons! Heroic nobles!
Alright.
Melee fighters ready! Heroic nobles!
Join up with the current army. Alright, see you soon, Ferret. Have fun with the work.
Forward! Stay together!
Alright, and then.
Sons of the Old Oak! Return to your positions!
Sons of the Oak?
Forward!
There we go.
Ancestors, honor us!
And then you guys. Over there. There we go. Reform the ranks. And now we wait. They were the attacker, so I assume they're going to attack us. Once the reinforcements actually arrive. Yep, there they go. Oh man. They're coming towards us. This is one of the few times in Total War that I actually am not the attacker. Which is quite interesting to see as well. I do hope slingers have a longer range than these guys. Alright, prove your worth, men of Britain, and defend our lands. And all that. This is scary. What's scary about it? Yeah, if we lose this battle, we're done. Pretty much. Then the invasion gets crushed before it even started. But if we win this battle, we may have just destroyed most of their forces. What are they doing? Spreading out? They've got the cavalry on the side, but we've got the cavalry too. You know. We'll just put the cavalry here on the side. Just in case they want to flank us. Fight and ride my cavalry. You usually end up defending. I usually end up one being the aggressor. With no cavalry at all, way too few ranged units. I'm a true Roman general when it comes to this game. Like, just heavy infantry marching in a straight line towards the enemy. I'm a big fan of the Roman way of fighting. Which doesn't always work well with these barbaric tribes. Since they don't hold out in a line usually. Very well. Very well. Alright, they're in range. They're being shot at.
Let
Our general is under attack.
We're being shot at. Our general is being shot at.
Scrap house ready! Then charge!
Oh, they're immediately trying to assassinate our general. Well, that isn't going to work. Not with light horses.
Heroic nobles! Get out!
You failed in your assassination attempt.
Veteran riders!
Oh, you want to flank us? Sorry. Got my own horses ready to intercept the flank. Boom. Alright. They're just gonna clash. Yeah. They're just gonna... Cavalry lost the fight.
Warriors of Britain, they will bleed for us. Battle ready!
Swordmen!
Flash the lines! No, no, it was not their general. It was their, one of their horsemen.
Battle ready!
Swift horsemen! They tried to assassinate my general. They attacked my general.
Melee fighters ready!
Okay, this is crap. Get out of range.
Move it!
Oh, I should just get shot to pieces. Okay, I don't know what happened here, but those range units...
Britons!
Really weird position.
Yeah!
Flank them!
Heavy freemen!
Alright. We're slowly enveloping them. Alright, these riders can just... They tried to assassinate my general with their cavalry, but they failed. Because light horse cannot assassinate...
One of our units has used all its ammunition.
Light horse cannot assassinate a general's unit. General's unit is way too powerful. Nope, no flankerino.
Scrappers ready.
Alright, we're gonna get flank ready. Here.
Move forward!
Yeah. And you guys are gonna flank these guys. Yeah, they failed miserably. Pretty much.
The men are wavering.
What men are wavering? We're doing good, man. Hold your ground! Oh. There you go.
Swordmen!
Okay.
Veteran riders!
Hold your ground, we're doing good. We are doing... Okay.
Levy freemen!
Alright, charge those.
Our men flee the field of battle. This is a shameful
hold
display.
Hold the ground. Stay with me. Don't flee a battle that we're winning. Hey, Doge. Yeah, unless they're chosen swordsmen or Roman legionaries. They're pretty OP. Uh-oh.
Run defense at speed. Up forward.
Yes, Doge. Run! Run from these spearmen! Alright, we still have a warrior's unit here.
Our men flee the field of battle! This is a shameful display!
Don't flee, guys! Don't flee! Alright, General, you are needed, sir. You are needed to save these units.
draw!
Our men flee the field of battle! One this is a shameful display.
Enemy freemen! Spearmen! Ready for battle!
How is this even possible? Alright. Time to turn this around. Do you live with any pets? Yeah, I live with
an entire unit has perished.
I live with bookfishes, Doge. Alright. She appears on gas from time to time.
Our men flee the field of battle.
Oh shit, this isn't going
this
to
is a shameful display.
Man, we got wrecked. Shit.
Our general has fallen.
Oh crap. Never mind. Hey Titan Powers, welcome to the stream.
We hunger for blood and battle.
Yeah, the tide has turned for the worst.
Our men flee the field of battle. This is a shameful display.
Veteran riders!
Oh man. Yeah, we're done. This campaign was over before it even started. I hope the Namont is still like us.
The enemy general is dead.
Retreat. The withdrawal button causes a unit or ship to leave the battle by traveling toward the edge of the field by the shortest route. It can be called back at any stage before it leaves by issuing a move or attack order.
Because that's just way too few damage.
Our general has fallen!
Retreat! Oh man.
Our men flee the field of battle! This is a shameful display.
Yeah. Damn! All family members are dead before they even got their careers off the ground. The invasion was stopped before it even started.
Britons! Pull back! Disbanding battle group!
Our men flee the field
Man.
Of battle! This is a
Ouch. Ouch. RIP invasion. Yeah, RIP invasion indeed.
Run! Making camp!
Oh man, not good, not good at all. Can we get new generals in here? Oh man, this is so RIP. Retreat to the city.
on the move, lads.
Retreat to the city. I don't care. Forced march.
Stragglers will be left behind.
For the tribe.
Get in there. Get into the city.
Call this a garrison.
Wait, you can't even make it with forced march? Damn.
Ready for order. Getting on our way. I want hourly patrols.
You always charge your range, Jun.
Thirsty for battle.
You can't recruit. Recruit new units quickly.
Death in battle. There is no finer ending.
Damn. No, this is so ripped for the... Oh, so ripped for the politics. Look at that. We're so dead in terms of political. And this all for a trade treaty. I hope they like us for it. Yeah, they like us a lot. Now give us the trade treaty.
The god.
Well, at least we have a trade treaty. There is that. No one plays as Rome. I'm currently playing a co-op campaign with Binary
Only
Ferret.
Only the greatest dare speak of peace to their enemies. Only
oh, yes,
the weak
yes.
seek the death.
I currently play a co-op campaign with Binary Ferret
unless it brings
that as Rome.
Here. So where's the what?
That's my team all day. Yeah, it's definitely better for my tactics. But,
ready
yep.
for battle.
People voted. I had a poll out for which race to play.
Steps.
And people voted for Britain.
For the tribe.
So, there you go.
Fight with us. It's a good life.
Therefore, I chose Britain. Since people wanted to see me, can you play it? It's too cliche. I guess that's why no one plays
Ready for battle.
Because it's too cliche.
For the tribe! Thirsty for
right,
battle.
Retrain these guys. Gives wealth. Shame. Yeah, well, we'll fix this.
Ready for battle.
I don't think we have the technology anyway. The military technology yet for anything better. Do we? I'm not sure. Bronze Forge? Basically, the invasion failed in one battle. Yup. Well, we did get peace from
tribe.
One of the sides, so now it's just 1v1.
To serve the people of Britain.
Ready for order.
Which is just making sure we've got our armies back up and then going at it again. It's on normal, Titan powers. It's on normal.
There is a time when
oh,
warriors
now they want
will sheathe
treaty.
The sword.
Okay. Fine. Give us some time to recuperate and get our forces back on. We've got what we needed anyway. Oh shit. Which was a trade treaty. Out of this war. We made the war so the Namnites would prefer us more. So, they would do a trade treaty. And that's what happened. So, peace. Let's,
For the tribe!
Let's retrain our troops and stuff. Give us some time to recuperate.
Death in battle! There is no
very
finer ending!
Okay.
For the tribe!
Man, the Rugi are really big. I actually want to engage these guys, but they're really big. How?
We will gladly listen to your offers, but do not wrap them in lies. The spirits know truth.
Interesting. Make war to make peace. Make war to gain money. That was the goal.
Warriors all!
Hail to the mother! How can I help?
Alright.
Thirsty for battle!
Alright. Oh, minus five, jeez. The public order. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, I have to once again ask for your help with a decision. A hag has been spotted rising from the mists of a stream. The local people fear she may be a sign of the gods, a sign of terrible misfortune to come. Do we bury a sacrifice? A hag is a sure sign of a bad harvest. We must make an offering to the gods of the earth to prevent the hag's malice poisoning our crops. Do we make votive offerings? The hag appeared in the stream. We must make offerings to the gods and goddesses of the rivers. Only they can protect her from malice. Or do we do nothing? If a hag has visited these people, they have obviously done something to deserve the wrath of the gods. There is nothing we can or should do for them now. What do we choose? Ladies and gentlemen, cast your votes. Make votive offerings. Oh, he's wounded. Oh, ouch. Marriage. Being sacrificed to egg is too severe of a punishment. Alright, votive offerings, it is. The Senate has spoken. Alright. Save the game. Take in the defeat. The Nervii proved too powerful. As Caesar has warned us, the Nervii were the fiercest of the barbaric tribes. In his Conquest of Gaul book. Land reclamation. Tribal economy. From the mists, the hag was never seen again and the gods allowed the people to continue as normal. Well, good job, guys. Good job. GG. Inspired population. Nice. Trade gained. Oh shit, minus six more. Oh, it's him. Never mind. One gravitas per turn. It's the general that doesn't go to war anyway, so that's fine.
Ready for battle. Are you ready to do your duty to the tribe?
I still want one slinger unit. Yeah.
Hail to the mother! How can I help?
Hail to the mother! You can help by actually defeating our enemies this time.
Warriors all!
Minus 17 then. But this time the Rugi will be our enemies. I hope that they can. That they are somewhat easily defeated. Averni, don't
want
to trade
freedom. Friend. We will speak together.
Nope. They're at war with the. With tribes we don't know yet, except for the Treveri. But we can't reach them because we did not win this war. Alright, let's see what technology we want. Tribal totem. Alright. Let's do a tribal totem. Get our units up to strength. Oh. Just a few relaxed years of recruiting after the defeat that was suffered. Man, that war maiden really does her job. She doles out that experience. Light infantry, split them up. Divide and conquer. All that jazz. I see. A foreign trader. Nice.
For the tribe! Ready for battle!
Can we do warfare? Warfare! Wait, that's the one we needed for military experience, right? I believe that was the one.
Hail to the mother! How can I help?
Right. Transfer over to
this
one.
Warriors all!
Since this army needs
Warriors
to train
all.
Its units first. I believe that, yeah. That's a turn of training.
For the tribe!
Yeah, now they're pissed at us. Whoa! The Nervii aren't pissed at us? Wow. Military actions. Post-war. Interesting. They aren't really... Oh shit, the Artrobates are conquering our trade partner. Damn it.
I live to serve the people of Britain!
If only we had won that war.
Hail to the mother.
Oh well. As always though, every hour I take a small break, and the hour is upon us. Take a small break of 3 to 4 minutes, not only to stretch legs, go to the toilet, take a drink, do whatever you want to do, you need to do, but also to cut it up into nice little pieces for the YouTube, for the YouTubes. And yeah. Those breaks usually last 3 to 4 minutes, so please bear with us as we go into the second part. But before we do, I leave you with a choice. Because once again, they bring before us a case for the people. A merchant from the distant south wishes to trade his incense and spices with our people. Do we allow him to monopolize? 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 The rich and fragrant spices are becoming popular, and controlling their trade will be profitable. Do we give it to the gods? These strange and exotic items will surely please the gods. Do we let him trade? Such exotic items will only improve our trade prospects. Or do we do nothing? What a merchant chooses to do at this time is of little concern to us. I leave you with this choice, and I will be right back after the break.